This is a role play developed as part of the course curriculum for Manage TB, an online course for doctors. The participants have enacted the roles given to them. The case discussed does not refer to any existing patient, but has been developed as part of the course curriculum. The investigations, such as x-rays and lab reports, used in this case scenario belongs to patients treated at National Institute for Research in Tuberculosis, Chennai. Their identity have been anonymized.
Very good morning to you, madam.
Good morning, Dr. Eril.
Ma'am, I have a case for you for a discussion.
Okay, please go ahead. We can discuss the case.
There is a 30-year-old woman who is a homemaker, has been on anti-tuberculosis treatment for the past 1 month, came to the clinic with a history of nausea and vomiting for the past 3 days.
Okay. Have you collected any other additional information for us to help manage this patient?
Yes, madam. She has no history of any fever, no abdominal pain, and there is no passing of loose stools. And she has 2 children, and she had undergone sterilization. Her last menstrual period was 2 weeks back. I have did thoroughly her systems, and also I did general examination. On general examination part, she is afebrile, there is icterus, she is not anemic. On local examination part, her abdomen is soft, but there is tenderness over the right hypochondrium. There is no girding or rigidity.
Have you ordered any investigations for this patient?
Madam, since the patient is on anti-tuberculosis medications, so we have to look for hepatic and gastrointestinal causes. So I have ordered for urine, for bile salts and bile pigments, and also LFT, which includes serum, bilirubin, AST and ALT.
Okay. If their liver function tests are reported as normal, what will be your line of management for this patient?
So, till that, I have to ensure the patient to take all the anti-tuberculosis medication without vomiting. I ask the patient to take the tablet along with the banana. I also ask the patient to have little water to drink. I also ask the patient to take the tablet along with the food, which makes the tablet palatable. If still the patient has vomiting, then I go for antiemetics and antacids to cure the symptom.
Okay, very good. When is the liver function test results expected?
Just now, madam. I received a message earlier. Madam, her result have arrived. Her serum bilirubin is 2.5 milligram per deciliter.
Okay.
Her AST is 60 international units and the ALT is 70 international units. She has jaundice. Her urine bile pigments is also positive.
Okay. So now the patient has developed jaundice while on anti-TB treatment. So how will your line of management be for this patient?
So in that case, I will stop rifampicin, isoniazid and pyrazinamide, and I start streptomycin with ofloxacin to ethambutol, and I continue the treatment.
Okay. So how will you monitor the progress of this jaundice when the patient is on these drugs which you just mentioned?
I'll have a close watch on the patient's LFT every week. So when the LFT comes to normal, okay, I reintroduce all the tablets which were stopped earlier.
Okay. So, fine, that is a very good management plan. So, can you please summarize what are the important discussion points from this case which we have discussed right now?
Yeah, definitely, ma'am. Nausea, vomiting in a patient on anti-TB drugs may be due to hepatic or gastrointestinal cause. Rifampicin, isoniazid and pyrazinamide have to be withheld in case of abnormal LFT. Streptomycin have to be added to ethambutol and treatment should be continued. Close monitoring with LFT is required in case of jaundice. Anti-TB drugs can be reintroduced if LFT returns to normal.